Merge sort and quick sort, or divide and conquer. But are they more efficient than the insertion and the bubble and the selection sort? Is the shell sort really much better than the insertion sort? Let's have a look. Let's use random numbers in different size lists and compare the times. Which algorithm do you think will come out on top? Let's remind ourselves of the six algorithms that we'll be timing. The basic idea of a bubble sort is simple. It compares each element with the next element and swaps their position if they are in the wrong order. It's called a bubble sort because the smaller elements bubble to the top of the list as the larger elements sink to the bottom. The selection sort, we find the minimum number remaining and swap it into the lowest place. So here we swap the 3 with the 8, 4's in the right place, 7 with the 8. The insertion sort looks at each element and makes sure that the elements up to the new one are all in order. In this example, we have 6 numbers. We go through the list and we check to see they're in order. Essentially, when we have a number that's not lower than a number previous to that, then we move it forward. So this way, the lower numbers I move towards the beginning until the list is in order. Now the shell sort makes the insertion sort more efficient by moving the lower numbers towards the beginning of the list. And it does this on several passes, in this example using 3, then going back to the insertion sort of 1. Now the merge sort has 2 parts. First of all, we split our list in half, half again, half again, until we have the single elements in the list. That's the divide part. Now we compare 2 elements and make sure they're in order, then 4 elements, so they're in order, and then our final list. That's the conquer part. Finally, the quick sort. We could choose one number, which we will call a pivot, and then move the lower numbers to the left of that and the higher numbers to the right. So what does this mean? Let's choose a pivot 4. Now, lower numbers to the left, higher numbers to the right. Now it's divide and conquer, so we will take the left-hand side, so we choose a pivot 2, lower numbers to the left, higher numbers to the right. Right-hand side, choose a pivot, lower numbers to the left, higher numbers to the right. So we end up with our sorted list. So what are we expecting from these algorithms? Let's compare them in ChatGPT. It says for small arrays, which we're going to start off with, the speed differs due to different details, implementation and hardware. General faster for small arrays are usually the simpler ones. So we've got insertion sort, tends to perform well on small arrays. Selection sort, it's quite similar. It says insertion sort generally outperforms selection sort, but for a small array, not much difference. Bubble sort's not very efficient. Now, the new ones, we've got merge sort, which is divide and conquer. Now, this might have an overhead at the beginning, so for small arrays, might not be that fast. Quick sort, again, divide and conquer, also has an overhead of the partitioning step. So the merge sort and quick sort, I'm not sure about efficiency on small arrays. Shell sort is really a variation of insertion sort, so it depends on what numbers come out really, but can perform quite well. So this isn't a scientific test, but we can see we've got the simple algorithms. We don't expect much from bubble sort, but the insertion and selection should be quite similar on small. Interesting what happens on larger arrays, and the divide and conquer algorithms maybe not so great on the smaller arrays, but when we have more, like more numbers for example, maybe their efficiency will tell then. So let's have a look. We've got the new sorting algorithms. We've got the merge sort, we've got the quick sort, and we've got the shell sort. So we've added that code to the bubble sort, insertion sort,
and the selection salt. Now, we're going to create some numbers. So here we've got 1,000 lists. We're going to start off, as we did before, with 6 numbers, and they're randomly selected from numbers 1 to 100. So we're going to have a list with 6 numbers in, and those 6 numbers are randomly from 1 to 100. Now we're going to create separate lists, make sure it works, and then run them using the bubble sort, selection sort, insertion sort, the newer shell sort, the quick sort, and the merge sort, and also we're going to use the default sorting algorithm, which is the TimSort in Python, to see how fast that is as well. So we compared the simple algorithms previously, and now we're going to compare them with the new 3. So we're going to start off with small arrays of list 6. So we're going to run the code first, and then because the divide and conquer algorithms are probably more efficient on larger arrays, then we're going to change the amount of numbers in the list to see if they're more efficient with larger lists of numbers. Okay, let's run our code. Okay, we have at the start our bubble sort, which we thought would be our slowest. Now, that's not as fast as the selection sort, and in this instance, insertion sort is even faster of our simple algorithms. Now, our shell sort has managed to outperform the insertion sort, so we can see our shell sort is a more efficient version of our insertion sort, even with smaller lists. Our merge and conquer algorithms are a lot slower because of the small lists, we have the overhead of the divide and conquer part. And in comparison to our default searching sorting algorithm, these are all a lot slower than the default. But now what happens when we use a different amount of numbers? Let's say we move up to 20 numbers. So now our list has 20 numbers rather than 6. Okay, we still had the bubble sort slower. Here we've got our selection sort has outperformed the insertion sort, both of which have been outperformed by the shell sort. So the shell sort is doing very well. Now our quick sort has managed to get close to the others, but not really close to the shell sort. And again, our merge sort is a lot slower. So we're going to have to use more numbers. Let's move the list size up to 50. Okay, so we can see our bubble sort still not very efficient. Here our selection sort outperforms our insertion sort, but our shell sort is much, much faster. And now we can see our divide and conquer algorithms start to perform at a reasonable level. So quick sort was the second most efficient using 50 numbers. So merge sort still a bit behind, but now faster than bubble sort, for example. Our default sort, much faster. Okay, finally, what happens if we run the program with lists of 100 numbers? Okay, so this is going to take a bit more time. Again, we can see our shell sort is the sorting algorithm with the best time. And now our divide and conquer are outperforming our simple algorithms. So you can see quick sort is outperforming merge sort. Both of them are being outperformed by shell sort. And you can see our default sorting algorithm in Python a lot faster than these. Now it's down to the implementation. So you can see that the default has been implemented very efficiently. Okay, let's run it again just to see the times are quite similar. So we can see the times are very similar. We can keep running it, and we should find sometimes the computer might have other operations. Our results are pretty uniform results, pretty consistent results every time we run them. So there's our simple and our divide and conquer algorithms. And at this moment in time, our shell salt is the most efficient. Finally, what happens if we run it for 500 numbers? Now, this is going to take some time. Now, the results with the list of 500 numbers, you can see our newer divide and conquer algorithms are much, much faster than the simple ones when we deal with large lists. So we can see the quick sort outperforms the insertion sort, selection sort, and bubble sort by quite a margin. Still quicker than the merge sort, but that is quicker than these other simple algorithms. And our shell sort still performs well. So that's quite interesting, even with lists of 500 numbers. We have obviously to wait a little while for these algorithms to perform the operations. But again, if you're wondering, the default algorithm is implemented efficiently. So we can use that if we really want to implement fast sorting. Okay, I hope you found those results interesting.